the hell he is, moron. He's just trying to lie out of it.
Lie dirt. You're just late for that, woman. You work for lately, you can haul a load every day. And I can have me some snuff when I want.
Tobacco Road. Over the years, the term has come to stand for the hardest kind of poverty. The play shows the rural South during the Depression, and the Depression's effect on one family, the Lester family, their struggle for turnips and snuff, and their daily existence from the land. The Lester family's views on life and their times have brought laughters and tears to audiences since 1932. Southerner Erskine Caldwell conceived the novel as a means of capturing this unique southern rural experience of poverty. The novel became a play in 1933, the worst year of the Depression, and after some initial false starts, it ran 7.5 years on Broadway. Erskine Caldwell is now 71. He went on to write God's Little Acre and other stories of the South, but his heart remains with Tobacco Road. He's come to Dallas to watch the Dallas Theater Center's portrait of his classic work of over 40 years ago.
These days, because there are very few people alive who can remember how tough life was in those days, because that was an era of great hardship, and people were deprived not only of food and so forth, but many people were deprived of an education, which was difficult to pursue because people didn't have the clothing to go to school, they didn't have the means of going to school. I wanted to be a storyteller, and I wanted to tell the story in the terms of realism, not in romance or not in comedy or tragedy particularly, but as a realistic story of life.
Erskine Caldwell told me that he never cared for the film version of Tobacco Road, mainly because it ended on a happy note. The author says that for the poor whites of the Depression, there were no happy endings. Arch Campbell, Channel 8 News.
So that had a lot to do with my attitude towards writing this story, the fact that it was hurting people, sociologically hurting people.
Do you consider Tobacco Road a social novel of that school of novels trying to change society?
Well, I'm not trying to, I never tried to change anything. I'm trying to depict something. I'm trying to show something that existed because I was writing what I consider realism. And realism is something that exists. And what I was doing was not to try to change the world. I was not a do-gooder in that sense because
Man, how old are you?
Well, right now I'm 70. Next week I'm going to be 71. And the week after that I'll probably be 72. That's the way I feel right now.
Well, at least we can say you are a survivor of the Depression.
Yeah.
A man who lived through the Depression and wrote about the Depression. What do you think would happen to today's generation if we had another depression like the great one in 29?
Well, you see, life has changed so much in the past half a century that the Great Depression of the 30s had its roots in the rural element of life, the farm life and so forth, the small town. Now that doesn't exist so much. Now we're urbanized. So what would happen now, I think, would be even more tragic than it was then, because people would be without the means of subsistence. Mm-hmm. In those days, maybe you could have a garden, you had a farm, or you could grow something to eat, or you could have a cow and a calf. But now in a city, in an urbanized existence, you don't have that to fall back on. So now people would just be begging and starving. I had an idea when I started out to write that the best way to be a writer was not to try to write a bestseller, because I was a book reviewer in my early damaged youth, working on a newspaper. I did a lot of book reviewing, and I found out that the bestseller themselves and the writers of bestsellers didn't last very long either. People were a flash in the pan, so to speak. And this came and went. So I didn't want that kind of a life to be, my life to be that way. So I decided very early that I didn't want any bestsellers. I didn't want to be a best-selling writer. I wanted to write a book that would be as good next year as it was this year.
Well, what did you think when suddenly, overnight, Tobacco Road was
such
a success?
Well, as a matter of fact, it was never a bestseller. Maybe over the years, sure. Mm-hmm. 40 years, then it adds up to being a bestseller, we'll say. But it was not immediate, overnight success by any means.
So maybe you realized your dreams that way, rather than having a bestseller, you had
A long time seller.
And that didn't surprise you?
No. No, it didn't surprise me a bit, because I planned it that way.
Tobacco Road is a story of extreme poverty, of the Depression. What kind of a statement were you trying to make in that novel?
Well, that's difficult to say now, because, you see, the Great Depression is a historical fact.